My name is Jess Jones. I'm a restoration biologist with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Today we're on the Powell River and we're releasing individuals of actually three endangered freshwater mussel species, the oyster mussel, the combshell, and the snuffbox. And so we've released about 6,500 mussels so far today. It's a big project, as you can imagine. Of course, Virginia Tech University is one of the major partners with the mussel lab there at the university. Myself with the Fish and Wildlife Service, but a number of Fish and Wildlife Service offices. The two field offices in Virginia, in Gloucester and in Abington, Virginia. Also North Carolina, the field office in North Carolina. And then the field office in Tennessee in Cookeville. So those four field offices have been very involved with the project over the last 5 years or so. And in addition to that, there's some very important state partners as well. Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency has also been very involved in the project. And also Virginia Department of Game and Fisheries, they also have a facility like ours at Virginia Tech called the Aquatic Wildlife Conservation Center, which is in Marion, Virginia. And that facility produces the same kind of mollusks that we do, mussels, and releases them primarily in the Virginia reaches of the Clinch and the Powell. Well, we're hoping we've done releases the last 2 years in a row, okay? So in 2010, 2011, and then here in 2012, and we'll probably do it for two more years. And we'll stock probably a half a dozen sites up and down the river. It's actually at this site that we're at right now, upstream of Brooks Bridge. We've been monitoring released individuals with pit tags at this site for about 3 years, and survival has been very high, above 90%, and the growth has actually also been excellent. So very good growth and survival of the mussels that we've released at this site. There's 13 federally listed freshwater mussels in the Powell. There's probably 35 mussel species altogether that still live in the Powell, so very high diversity. It has the second highest number of endangered freshwater mussels in the United States. The most endangered mussels occur in the Clinch River, which this river flows into. Historically, there's been a number of pollution sources. The small towns along the river that had inadequate treatment for the wastewater from homes and small businesses located along the river, mining, forestry, some industrial practices like that over the years have had an impact on the river. We're hopeful that some of these sources of pollution have got under control, and these lower reaches of the Powell down in Tennessee especially, we're seeing we're seeing the mussel population stabilize down here, and we're seeing recruitment of the endangered mussels and the common species. So that's a really good sign that the river is the water quality is good and suitable for releasing the mussels that we're releasing today. Freshwater mussels are one of the best indicators we have that the river is doing well, because if the river is heavily polluted, they just cannot handle a lot of pollution. So they're much more sensitive to pollution than the fish or the aquatic insects or some of the other species that live in the river. So they're one of the best indicators that the water quality is good and that the river is clean.